Hi guys, it's me, LDL, with Listening Over, with a new review for you. It's been a while, and today I'm going to do a quick review of the doll inspired by Emma Watson from Disney's live-action Beauty and the Beast. So, let's begin! Let's check out her box. Her box is not bad. It's quite good, actually. You can see Emma Watson as Belle from the film collection, and you can see their embroideries on the box. It is quite small for the gown of this doll. But it's a beautiful box, a classic of the film collection. And they are all like this. This time it was a twist that it was shaped like a house almost. But it is a nice box. You can see the image of Beauty and the Beast here. Yeah, the logo of Beauty and the Beast. And a description of the film collection dolls. The price is 36 euros or 45. 34 and 95. These boxes are so much easier to open and easy to unbox. Even though there are a lot of stuff to keep them together and perfect in place, we can already see the dress and the beautiful shoes. And here I'm cutting some clips. Yes. So, let's see her from up close. Her face has been quite controversial, as you may know, but it's not too bad, actually. She has nice hair, nice brown hair, as Emma, and it's not bad at all, this too. An earring, beautiful earring, painted on. Like Emma does in the movie, and we can see me playing with that with the chunk of hair. Now there is that necklace, beautiful necklace, and beautiful bodice. It is fully articulated gold, beautiful necklace, and all the embroidery that is like the one that descends from the ceiling in Beauty and the Beast, but the model of the dress is not too similar to the one in the movie because it is a prototype version of the dress that was made by Disney to, I think, not as the official dress, and is not like the movie but beautiful. You can see the back is gorgeous, and all the sparkles that are everywhere in my room now, but not too bad. And now we can see the six layers dress. Here I am struggling counting the six layers because I can't count, and I didn't go to school for math. Okay. And yes, we can see the beautiful chiffon layers and a satin layer with an underskirt and some paper to keep it puffy and beautiful. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and she falls. Okay, now let's check out her shoes that are beautiful. Beautiful job, Disney Store. As always, these shoes, if they can do shoes, I can do shoes, but they, in the classic doll, they always choose flats, and even for Cinderella sometimes, and that's scandalous. But these shoes are beautiful. She, of course, is fully articulated. Amazing articulations. Here again, we have the back of the dress and her hair. Her hair is beautiful. She has a braid. No, she doesn't have a braid. She has a braid, a flare, whatever it's called, and a bun with a braid. And we here, I'm struggling to cut a clip from the dress, but I cut the fabric in this part. It isn't too obvious, but beautiful background of a room, and here she is, beautiful. She does fit in all the other live action ladies. Yeah, beautiful camera work, Luca, And here they are, some of my live action ladies. I love this collection, and Emma is perfect and fits perfectly in this collection. I hope you enjoyed this review, and subscribe and like and comment. Bye! And if you were wondering, I didn't turn her into Justin Bieber, I turned her into Hermione. I hope you like her, because that skirt looks like a Snow White skirt. It's like it was made for Snow White. I hope you like her. Bye! Sorry for my English.